Hello guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So we are back with our former format. So this is the screen where I'm going to teach you a lot of interesting questions. So let's begin today's video. But before that, if you have not subscribed to our channel, then you know what you have to do. You have to subscribe and hit the bell notification because it is going to keep you guys updated about the new uploads that we make on our channel. And this is the Telegram group which you can join if you want to have any queries related to the course or related to the examination. So you can ask your queries there, and also you can get the free quizzes that we provide you on this platform. So the link of this Telegram group is in the description below, so you can click on that link and join this Telegram group. And before moving ahead, I would like to give you a brief introduction about the RBI Grade B 2022 course, guys. So if you are here for the first time, then you should know that what we are going to offer you in our new RBI Grade B 2022 course. So here you will get PDFs, videos, mocks, and also the mock interview. So we prepare you guys for your final interviews of RBI Grade B as well by conducting your mock interviews. And this is the booklet that you will get. In this booklet, you can get all these books mentioned right in front of you. And this is the 30% discount that we are running on the course, which you can avail by using the RBI30 coupon code. And this is the number which you can dial if you have any query related to the exam or related to our course. Okay, so let's begin our video. But before that, let's have something for our motivation. The only person you should try to be better than is the person you were yesterday. What an amazing statement made by this person. Do you know who is this person? This person is someone who has achieved a great feat recently in the field of tennis. So who is this person? He is Novak Djokovic. And the first question is from him only. So who has won the Wimbledon Grand Slam Tennis Tournament 2021 in men's single? So you would have known the answer by now. It is Novak Djokovic, who is a Serbian tennis player. But who has won this Grand Slam tournament in the women's category? So it is Ashley Barty, who is an Australian player. Now guys, this is the first time that Ashley Barty has won this tournament, but it is the 20th time for Novak Djokovic to win a Grand Slam tournament, and this is his career's 6th Wimbledon tennis tournament victory. So this is something that you should not be remembering, of course, but this is this statement was to highlight how great his personality is. And we have already come across the thought process of this person, that the person that you have to become better is none other than yourself. You have to become better day by day with yourself. Okay, so that was all about this question, Wimbledon Grand Slam Tennis Tournament, which was won by Novak Djokovic in the male category and Ashley Barty in the female category. He is a player from Serbia and she is from Australia. Now let's move on to the second question, which is very important for all of us, particularly from your exam point of view. So which of the following banks is acting as the service center of the Ministry of Defense System for Pension Administration Raksha portal? So this Sparsh portal has been recently launched by Ministry of Defense. And what is the purpose of this portal that I'm going to tell you? But first, let's discuss which banks are going to act as the service centers under this portal. So State Bank of India, Punjab National Bank, Union Bank of India, both A and B and both B and C are in the options, out of which option D is the right answer. That is State Bank of India and Punjab National Bank, which are the two major banks that are holding a major chunk of defense pension accounts. So these two banks are going to act as the service centers for this Sparsh portal. Now what is this Sparsh portal? So this Sparsh portal has been launched in order to automate the entire process of selecting the pensioners, of disbursing the pension. So this entire process is going to be automated through this portal. Okay, so that is one thing about this portal. Now, if the entire process is automated without involving any human, then where would the pensioners go for resolving their queries? So in order to provide all the information related to the pension, these banks have been selected as a service center. So here, the defense pensioners will get all the information they need for in relation to their pension at these banks under this portal. So that was all about this question. Now we are moving on to the next question. I hope that this question is clear to you guys. There is nothing much that you need to remember here, but yes, do not ignore the full form of SPARSH, the system for pension administration raksha, because this can also be asked from you in your examination. Now I would like to ask a question from you. This Union Bank of India is the nodal bank of a very important central scheme of Ministry of Food Processing and Industry. Can you name that scheme, guys? Because this bank and this ministry entered into the memorandum of understanding, entered into an MOU particularly for that scheme. And thereby, because of that MOU, this bank became the nodal agency for that scheme. So you have to name that scheme. Okay, so the next question is, which of the following GI certified flour has been recently exported to US and Dubai from Tamil Nadu? So again, we have a new product in the list of exports that we are making to different countries, particularly GI certified agricultural or horticulture products. So here the flour has been exported to US and Dubai. Which flour is it? So you have the five options which you can read on your own. Out of these five options, the right answer is option B, Madurai Malli. So this is the flower, but this is not the only flower. There was button rose as well, there was lily, and there were other flowers like marigold was also there, which were exported to US and Dubai. But this is particularly important because this is the GI certified flower. It got its GI certification back in 2013 and it belongs to Tamil Nadu. Guys, can you name any three products that have been recently exported to different countries? Three GI certified products that I have taught you that have been recently exported to different countries in the comment section below, along with their states. Okay, so name the products along with their states. The next question is, with which African country has India signed an MOU to strengthen and promote bilateral cooperation in personnel, administration and governance reforms? Gambia, Mauritius, Lebanon, Seychelles, Madagascar, out of which Gambia is the right answer. Now here I would like to tell you that whenever you are doing any country, any news related to any country, your responsibility is to cover the capital, currency, location of that country on the map, because obviously your location would not be asked from you, but yes, it is for your general awareness that you should know where that country is located in the world map. The next point is the president or the PM of that country, which one is the chief of that country. You have to memorize that at present. Okay, and this particular component you can escape for the time being. You can only memorize this component whenever the exam is near. For example, if you have your exam in August, then all the countries that are in the news in the month of July, particularly memorize the presidents or prime ministers of those countries. Okay, so for the time being, till your examination is not announced, you can escape this component, but not all these three components, because they are static, they are not going to change. Next question is, high level energy laser for multiple applications power, which is short formed as HELMA P, is a laser powered cannon capable of destroying a moving drone, is of which country? So which country has developed this HELMA P? Denmark, Israel, Germany, France, and United Kingdom are the options, out of which France is the right answer. Now, the very basic purpose of this weapon or this cannon is provided in the question itself, that is to destroy the moving drones. Now, what is the purpose of developing such a weapon? Any weapon is developed for protecting the country, for protecting the air, land, or the sea of that country, or the waters of that country. So, first purpose is to protect the airspace of France. And the major purpose here is to protect the upcoming 2024 Olympics that are going to take place in Paris. Now, what does it mean by protecting the Olympics? Basically, flying drones have a potential to spy, potential of spying on the Olympic results, or it can also be used for harming the Olympics or destroying the entire event. So, in order to escape, in order to prevent such an event from happening, this laser-powered cannon will be deployed so that the event can go smoothly. Now, since we have talked about the Olympics, now let us go through the entire calendar for Olympics, because this is very important. Any one of the locations can be asked from you in your examination, so do memorize it very thoroughly. Okay, Summer Olympics, first of all, 2024 is going to be in Paris. 2021, basically 2020 edition is going to be held in Tokyo in July only. Okay, 2028 is going to be in Los Angeles. 2022 Winter Olympics is going to be held in Beijing. 2026 Winter Olympics will be held in Milano Cortina, an Italian city. Youth Olympics for 2020 in Switzerland. 2026, basically it was the postponed version of the 2022 Youth Olympics. So in 2026 it is going to be held in Senegal. So that is the entire calendar of the Olympics in the upcoming years that you should be remember, that you should remember for your upcoming examinations. And this is the last question, guys, for today. Who is the new US ambassador to India? So you have the five options: Mark Kelly, John Boozman, Tom Cotton, Eric Garcetti, Diana Feinstein, out of which option D, Eric Garcetti, is the right answer. So he is a mayor from Los Angeles and he has been appointed as the US ambassador to India. Now, here you would be thinking that are we supposed to remember all the ambassadors appointed by different countries to India? So here my answer would be no. Only remember the ambassadors appointed by the major superpower of the world, like US. And there is no other superpower than US. Okay, so the major countries like US, like Russia, Netherlands, China, so all these countries which remain in the news, particularly in touch with India because of India, whenever these countries are in the news, then only you can remember the ambassadors of those countries. For example, if Finland's ambassador to India proposes any new project, then he becomes important. Then you should remember his name, okay? Not otherwise. So that was all for today. I hope that you have enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching the video. And if you have learned something in this video, then do not forget to like the video. Thank you so much.